Hello and welcome to my shop. A friend of mine is a carpenter. He asked me to mend a set of holders supporting the table of his table saw. I planned to mill a flat steel plate, reduce the thickness of the original part and join both together. All faces of the hot rolled bar were milled to size. The top and bottom faces were first milled with a 20mm carbide end mill. As the surface finish wasn't satisfactory, I switched to a 40mm high-speed steel shell end mill. Finally, the plate was milled to length. The original parts were temporarily glued together and the new plate sandwiched underneath the original. The locations of both parts will be fixed by means of dowel pins later. Here you can watch me scribing the approximate location of three pinholes. The exact location is by no means critical, but the holes should be square to the work. By the way, I'm using a pretty crappy cheap set of calipers for scribing. The location of each hole was center drilled. .8mm through holes were drilled. A 4mm reamer brought the holes to exact size. With the pinholes finished, the next task was to determine the exact location of the M16 thread. I borrowed a threaded bolt from my trusty dividing head and screwed it into the original threaded hole. A dial test indicator was used to determine the exact position. The center drill fixed the location of the hole in the new steel plate. A 9mm hole was drilled through the plate. It will be bored out to 16mm later. The parts will be joined with two countersunk screws. For this purpose, I drilled two 4mm pilot holes. Next, I had to mill 10 millimeters, that is the thickness of the steel plate, off the back of the original part. Work holding was a bit tricky here, as the temporary bonded joint wouldn't withstand the forces of the milling process, probably. Thus, I bolted the old part onto the new plate and mounted both in the vise. Two parallels ensured a correct parallel alignment of the part. The material was hocked off the back of the part with a 20 mm carbide end mill. At the end, I took very light cuts as the remaining connection became very thin and the part was retained by the single M16 bolt only. Here are the parts almost ready to be pinned and bolted together. I drilled two 5 mm holes for M6 threads. Tapping the M6 threads finished the part. Two 6 mm holes were drilled and countersunk to receive the bolts. Time to join the parts. High tensile epoxy glue was mixed. Both surfaces were degreased with acetone and the glue was applied. The parts were loosely bolted together . Finally, the dowel pins were hammered in and the bolts tightened. The slot was milled with a 16mm carbide end mill. I had to move the spindle plus minus 1mm in Y to widen the slot to the required width of 18mm. Off camera I side milled the 45 degrees angle and did some cleanup work. So here are the finished holders. The moment of truth. After some fiddling, the table matched the body of the saw perfectly. That's it for today. Thanks for watching.